In supermarkets across the United States, Australia, and Japan, eggs can be found in the refrigerated section and absolutely should be stored that way in these places. However, in most other countries of the world, egg can be found stored at room temperature alongside non-perishable food items, and it's totally fine. So why is no refrigeration okay with some countries' eggs and others need it? In a word, salmonella. In more words, how different countries deal with salmonella on our breakfast butt nuggets. Salmonella enters eggs through one of two ways, via contaminating the egg internally before the hen lays it, when the hen's ovaries have been infected, or via the porous eggshell and its initial poopy surroundings. Egg producers in the United States address the salmonella problem with eggs by concentrating on preventing the bacteria from entering through the shell. Towards this end, the United States Department of Agriculture mandates that all eggs be washed with water at a minimum temperature of 90 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 32 degrees Celsius, and at least 20 degrees warmer than the internal temperature of the egg at the time of washing. If it were colder than the egg, this could result in a very slight contraction sucking in contaminated water through the shell's pores. The eggs will also be washed with some form of detergent and chemical sanitizer like chlorine, then are rinsed again and thoroughly dried. After this, the eggs are often sprayed with some form of protective coating like mineral oil. Finally, the eggs are stored at temperatures at or below 45 degrees Fahrenheit or 7 degrees Celsius. This effectively deals with the external sources of salmonella. However, this does nothing to destroy any salmonella potentially already present within the egg. This is where the refrigeration comes in. By keeping the eggs sufficiently cold, it mostly makes sure any salmonella present will not multiply sufficiently to cause problems given a couple months shelf life, keeping the eggs safe to eat so long as they are cooked. As for the other side of this, European nations and others rely on alternate methods to keep the salmonella problem in check. For starters, the European Union prohibits egg producers from washing their eggs. You see, shells have a natural protection from salmonella and other contaminants via a waxy substance known as the cuticle. The cuticle coats the shell initially as a liquid when the hen lays the egg and then dries within minutes of being exposed to the air. Egg washing not only washes away contaminants, but also removes the cuticle and its natural protections, potentially allowing bacteria to get into the egg via its pores or hairline cracks, particularly if washing isn't done just right. Thus, the EU and others deem it safer to cut out the potentially error-prone middleman and simply leave the cuticle on. Unfortunately, in this scenario, you'll get the occasional egg with fecal matter or the like on it. This also increases the chances of cross-contamination with handling the potentially contaminated eggshells and then perhaps touching other food items without washing your hands. But both of these problems are easily solved by simply washing the eggs and your hands directly before using them. So the cuticle solves the problem of external sources contaminating, but what about existing internal contamination and more rapid growth at room temperatures? They mandate that their egg-laying chickens must be vaccinated against salmonella, among other requirements, if they are to receive the Lion Quality Code of Practice seal. The result of this is that pretty much any egg sold in a major retailer outlet will come from vaccinated chickens. It should also be noted that in the US, while mandatory chicken vaccinations aren't a thing, in recent years many egg producers now do it voluntarily, owing to the fact that hen houses and eggs are continually tested for salmonella contamination, and positive results mean egg farmers must break all the eggs open from an entire batch and pasteurize them, leading to significant profit loss. Not to mention, any salmonella outbreak can result in a major recall of their product, such as one in 2010, which saw 500 million eggs need recalled. So which way of storing eggs produces fewer cases of salmonella-induced food poisoning? Unsurprisingly, the data seems to indicate both methods work great, but in the past, giving the edge to the European way, presumably owing to the whole chicken vaccination thing. Although, as noted, in very recent years, this has become more and more common in the US. Further, if you've got a refrigerator handy, it is superior in one regard. Eggs that are not refrigerated have a shelf life of about 3 weeks. Those stored in a typical consumer's refrigerator, however, are generally good for about 2 months, and drastically longer, upwards of a year, given better regulated temperatures, something that used to be key to keeping eggs on the supermarket shelves year-round, given chickens naturally stop laying eggs in the winter in response to shorter daylight hours. Now, of course, artificial lighting keeps the chickens popping out their tasty period excretions year-round. Speaking of eggs, ever wonder what the difference is between brown and white eggs? Well, if you click the video here, you'll wonder no more, and can then feel smugly superior to all the plebeians the world over who don't know. Which is, of course, most of the point of this channel.